The role a scriptwriter play may not be widely known or acknowledged, but undoubtedly is very much significant. A lot of people tend to look at scriptwriters as minor players in any kind of production. Join us as we rediscover the potent role scriptwriters play in the Philippines' film and television industry. Let's get to know the person and the art behind the name Roy Iglesias.
I discovered the interest in writing when I was young, maybe around 8 years old, nine. It was when I started writing, and I was interested in writing short stories, and then much later I started writing poems. But it was in high school when I got interested in the theater. Theater ako nagsimula. So I got exposed to theater productions. I wrote plays until later in college. That's when I got interested in film and television. So I took up mass comm. So, and then came the opportunity to write a screenplay when I was still in college.
In 1974, the 17-year-old Iglesias won his first recognition, surprisingly in directing and not in writing. The Plum was sponsored by the Department of Public Information Broadcast Bureau. With this first award, we might think it was already big, but here goes a bigger one, a Best Screenplay Award for the film he co-wrote with one of local cinema's best director, Eddie Romero. The film classic, Ganito Kami Noon, Paano Kayo Ngayon, brought Roy Iglesias in a stature so difficult to reach. He was young and just starting, yet so successful.
The nice thing about being a writer is that you work in the privacy of your own room. You don't have to dress up for your work. You're able to develop or create a world that is going to be given life by other people.
It took him 5 years to make up his mind and write another story. In 1980, he wrote a script for Hayop sa Ganda. Roy also made several projects with our nation's national artist for film, Lino Broca. He wrote Experience in 1983 together with Jose Lacaba, Tatlong Mukha ng Pag-ibig, silid episode in 1989, Biktima, which he co-wrote with Jose Delisay in 1990, and Sa Kabila ng Lahat in 1991, which won Best Picture in the Star Awards and the Young Critics Circle. In 1995, Roy worked with director Chito Ronyo in Dahas, Istokwa, and the docudrama Escapo.
I like working with Roy. First of all, he's very intelligent. Nagkaka-vibes kami when we look at the dark side of things. On the dark side of things. Si Roy, ano yan eh? Medyo dark din yan eh. He knows what I'm talking about whenever I... If you look at the house and babae sa bintana, well, you will see babae sa bintana. They're really on the darker side, you know.
People just saw the sex, no? But they didn't see the other aspects of it, the other layers of the movie. And that's what I love doing. I love doing films or teleplays that can be appreciated on one level. And yet, if you want to look for more meaning, you can still find them.
Pati nga San Pedro, dumalo sa akin eh. Kinamusta kita. Pati si Satanas. Tumalaw sa akin, kinamusta rin kita.
The Has, it gave Maricel her, I think it's her first Best Actress Award from Famas. And another thing, I'm sorry. That's her second Best Actress Award after Separada. And then she got again I think, 3 Best Actress Awards for Nasaan Ang Puso, which Roy Iglesias wrote. And this came from Metro Manila Film Fest, and one for FAMAS, and one for PAP, F-A-P.
Bakit may kahapon pa? Well, because it transcended several periods. I mean, it started in the 70s and up to the 90s. It's a political movie that tackled oppression and vengeance. It was well done, it was well written, well researched.
Do you know Broca Days pa? I don't remember na. Victima. We worked together since late 80s. But with Roy, kasi he comes up with the terminologies na kuminsan, hindi ko alam, pero ganun pala yun. Alam ba, tungkol sa police, he comes up with this mga police language na hindi ko naman alam.
When I write, I imagine the character and I imagine the place where he lives. I imagine his world. I go into the world of the character. I feel the feeling of the character. So before I write a line of dialogue, I have to feel that, the feeling of that character, that very moment, for that line of dialogue to come out.
Succeeding in two fields or genre is difficult to achieve. But with Roy, it's like the weighing scale is always balanced. Just as his scripts earned citations, he also got positive reviews for scripts he wrote for television.
Working with Roy, I think as far as script genres are concerned, it runs the gamut of from musical variety to several drama scripts, practically a lot of talk shows. So practically, Roy and I have worked on most of the genres or formats that television can offer. It's like I said, he gives the director certain cutting points. So his script is very, very visual. It's easy to visualize his script. It's easy to put it in film or on tape because, and to put images into it. It's easier. It's not a script that it drags, that you know it goes on and somehow it doesn't work.
This has been Lauren Ligada for Pep Talk. Thank you and good night.
Roy, I've known him for a very long time and he was one of my finest writers while we were doing Pep Talk then. That was a feature magazine program in 1986 when ABS-CBN reopened after EDSA. What other projects? Well, basically it was as head writer of Pep Talk. Apart from doing the program, before we reformatted the program, Pep Talk to Inside Story, we decided to put all the scripts together and rewrite them into a shorter version in not script form, but in narrative. And therefore we came up with Pep Talk, the book. That was way back in 1986, so it's been more than 10 years. And hopefully, if plans don't miscarry, then we will have a new program together, which will be a monthly documentary special.
To me, it's a wonderful opportunity to have worked with her. At the time when I was working with her, when she was doing Pep Talk, I didn't realize she was going to be a senator. So it's nice to be a part of someone's life, especially someone who has succeeded, no?
Well, Roy's scripts are profound, lyrical, well thought of. It's got depth and substance. Sometimes he is romantic, but his scripts are always substantial.
Roy Iglesias is a police reporters na...
And you tell them, no!
Tuloy-tuloy na...
When I review all of the works that I've done, I've seen and I've noticed a recurrence of social messages. That's something I've noticed. There is somehow, even if it's just a melodrama, there's a social message that's stuck into it.
Roy also had the rare chance of working closely with the centennial presidents of our country, Fidel V. Ramos and Joseph Ejercito Estrada.
Not a minute is wasted with the president, with President Ramos. And I think I had 2 days with him observing the things that he did. Also a memorable experience because I was given the opportunity to work with him up close. He asked me to just stick around, observe everything that I do. And I saw how he worked. No? He was really a workaholic. Yeah, well, that was of course an opportunity I didn't want to pass, no? Because a historical moment, a historical event. So but I was lucky because I was contacted also by the president. Specifically, the brother, Mr. Ejercito, Jesse Ejercito. I don't know why I was contacted. Maybe because of the works that I've done. But I don't know on what base, what specific work. And maybe also because of the trust, no? Because in a big project like that, you have to work with someone you can rely on. No?
I've done quite a number of projects with Roy. Would you believe comedy?
And that in due time, I could clap them softly. One, come on everyone. Two, three. So I sing sha-la-la-la-la.
I know Roy's been known as more of a dramatic type of writer, but a lot of people are amazed at I'm always working with him, especially in comic works.
The lady who relinquishes her throne and crown, Antoinette.
Beauty pageants are what we started with, but we've worked on some launchings, some hotel shows, various. No, it's not just beauty pageants.
Beautiful lyrics, very poetic, and his command of Filipino is so admirable.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know very many writers who can do that, who have that command in this day and age. And he works fast.
I don't even think I have the credibility to describe his work. Because maganda is like I said, the work that he's done for that we've done together before and this work now, it's just amazing how somebody can write that way.
Truly, Roy Iglesias is a jack of all trades. He is one writer who's well-versed in almost all fields of mass media.
To me, you are a writer that soars. You are the perfect Jonathan Livingston Seagull. As a writer who flies all over. Good luck. Don't direct. Don't get me out of my job.
You're a comment. You always flash in the sky.
The way I know Roy, mahihain tao yun eh. Roy, for us all, next time, assert your rights, assert your authority, assert your genius. You gotta assert and make people realize. Because I will not ask him to believe in himself, he already does, and a lot of people believe in him.
Let's keep on working, Roy. I know you're good, but keep on working.
Well, to Roy, I wish you all the best in the horror movie by Quintana. You've done a good job with this one. I hope you win a lot of awards this coming year. Thank you, thank you.
I'm familiar with his works, like Irving. Isaac, of course, my ina-anak, and Ivan, no, the second son. Those are Roy's better works with a co-worker, co-producer, Senaida Pascua.
You're there already, you've arrived, except that you are a very harsh critic of yourself and of your work. But I guess this is yet one of your best years, and we're always there for you.
What I think should happen more in our job is that we be given more recognition. Kasi the way it looks, writers are not really given that much recognition. The respect is there, but of course, the more visible people are the ones who get recognized. No?
The next time you see a well-crafted movie, a good teledrama, a well-conceptualized special event, we hope that you'll remember that it was done not just by the frontliners alone, but together with the director. Unseen, there stands the scriptwriter.
Packaging an Indian epic into a modern love story.
Mommy. We'll have a gala at the UP Theater. The cast consists of top movie and theater actors and recording stars. It will be a different interpretation of the Ramahari, a famous project of the Ballet Philippines in the 80s. Cherry Mercado has this report.
This is not Aladdin. It's Rama Sita, a play based on the most famous Indian epic, the Ramayana. It's a love story that tells of the struggle of Rama and Sita to stay together despite lustful propositions from Ravana and Surfanaka. Jazz singer Jaya plays the witch Surfanaka. Robert Sena of Miss Saigon is the bad guy Ravana. Musical director Danny Tan tailored the music for the characters. Ravana and Surpanaka sing soul music. The play opens with Rama being banished from his father's kingdom because of bickerings among his family.
Portrays a lot of sentiments also that is very common to Filipinos. Sentiments like love for family, love for brothers, sisters, and of course, a lot of things that can happen in a sitcom, although in a Philippine sitcom. So there's comedy, there's intrigue. In other words, the theme is actually universal. So it doesn't mean to say that because it is a Hindu epic, the Filipinos will not be able to relate to it.
Other actors involved in the play include Ariel Rivera and Raymond Lauchenko, who alternate as Rama. Chiki Pineda and Metropop Festival winner Lani Misalucha alternate as Sita. SK Entertainment, a Singapore-based production outfit, is spending 40 million pesos on the production. The money reportedly came from a Brunei royalty. Director and set designer Leo Rialp is optimistic Rama at Sita will be warmly welcomed by the Filipino audience. Cherry Mercado, ABS-CBN News.
The depth of your partner.
Anin mo lang kung ano talaga ba yung pinaka gusto niya. I-discover mo kung ano pa yung hindi mo alam.
You see each other less often.